I would like to show you guys how to use the chain rule twice for taking the derivatives with trig functions. So we have to remember the derivatives for sine, cosine, tangent, cosecant, secant, and cotangent. And if you want some tips on how you can remember these derivatives, well, I have a video for you in the description. Check that out. All right, let's get started with the first one, differentiating the square root of sine of 3x. So as you can see, first off, we have this box here, square root of this. So the first step is to differentiate the square root. That's the outer function. And the derivative for square root is 1 over 2 square root. And then you just put the box in there, right? And of course, you write down the function, which is sine of 3x. Then we are going to differentiate the inside. The derivative of sine is cosine, so we multiply by cosine. But as you can see, here inside we have the 3x. So the 3x stays inside of the cosine. And then the last step is we have to look what's inside of the box. The derivative for the 3x is 3, so multiply by 3. That's it. So the chain rule one time, and then here's the chain rule for the second time. So that's it. Oh, I'll box this in red to make it stand out more. And I'm not going to simplify. You can put this on the top and all that, but let's just focus on the derivative, the calculus depth, all right? All right, for the number two, here we have the derivative for cosine of e to the 1 over x. So as you can see, the outer function is the cosine. So we have cosine of the box. What's the derivative of cosine? Sine and cosine are best friends, right? And the derivative of the core function is negative. So we will first get negative, and then we get sine, because sine and cosine are best friends in calculus. And then the inside stays, we write down e to the 1 over x. And then we differentiate this. And the derivative of e to the 1 over x. And the 1 over x is really like another function. The derivative of e to the box is e to the box, which is just that again. Just repeat that. But finally, we differentiate the very inside, the derivative of 1 over x, which is negative 1 over x squared. Just like that. And again, we are done. Negative times the negative is positive, but I will leave that to you guys. I think this is more clear on what exactly to get the derivative. Now, number three, as we can see, the outer function is this to the third power. So we really have this thing as like the box to the third power. That said, we will have to use the power rule first. Bring the 3 to the front and minus 1. So the first step is we have 3, and then inside is 1 plus tangent, and then the 2x. Just write that down. And 3 minus 1, we get the second power here. All right, now we are going to differentiate the inside. The derivative of 1 is just 0. The derivative of tangent and secant are best friends in calculus. The derivative of tangent is secant, but to the second power. You have to remember that. So we multiply by secant to the second power, and then we also have that inside, which is the 2x. So maintain that 2x, take the derivative of 2x, which is 2. So multiply by that, that's it. Now, number four, we have cosecant square of 3x. And this notation, it's really like saying the following. This is the same as saying taking the derivative of cosecant 3x and then square. So what we really have is an input, like a box like this, and then to the second power. So bring the power to the front and minus 1. So first we will have 2 at the front, and then the inner function for the box, right? So cosecant of 3x to the first power, because 2 minus 1. Then we differentiate the inside. The derivative of cosecant is negative cosecant, also with cotangent, right? First, remember cofunction, we have negative derivative, and cosecant and cotangent best friend. cosecant is the one that repeats, just like secant. And you also invite its best friend here, which is cotangent. And then the input, which is 3x. Just maintain that. Right, so that's that part. And finally, notice that the very inside, the 3x, right, the derivative of that is 3. So just like that. So this right here is the derivative for that. Next, we have square root of 1 plus secant x squared. So we can see that this right here is the inner function. Therefore, we are going to first differentiate the square root. So that's that for that. We have 1 over 2 square root, and just put inside here, 1 plus secant of x squared. And then we differentiate inside. The derivative of 1 is 0. The derivative of secant, well, yes, it's going to be secant and tangent. So let's write down secant. And remember, you just maintain the inside. This is like a box right here, right? So secant of x squared. And also we need a tangent of x squared. The derivative of secant, first is repeat, and then you also invite its best friend, which is tangent. And you just maintain the x squared inside for both of them. Lastly, the derivative of x squared is 2x. So we multiply by 2x, just like that. So chain rule twice. I will tell you, it's not so bad. Just kind of calm down, practice a few more. You should just try the last one before you watch the solution. Done? All right, let's have a look. First here, we have e to the cotangent order, right? So it's e to the box, like so. And the derivative of e to the box is just e to the box. So the first step is e, and then we just repeat that in the exponent, so cotangent of pi x. Then we differentiate the box. The derivative of cotangent is, well, cofunction is negative derivative, so it's going to be times negative. Of course, use parentheses, otherwise it looks like a subtraction. It's a multiplication here, so parentheses. Negative, and we have cosecant square. This is very similar to tangent. The derivative of tangent is secant square. The derivative of cotangent is cosecant square, but has negative. And then we maintain the input, which is pi x. Input is this. And lastly, of course, we differentiate pi x. And that pi is just a number, you know, 3.1415, all that. So we multiply by pi. And that's it. So this is how you do the derivative with the chain rule twice. And of course, you also need to know the derivatives of all these trig functions. That's it.